Hi everyone, I am Dr. Satya Suren, a veterinarian and an animal nutritionist. This is your YouTube channel, Anything About Animals. This channel is meant to educate people and farmers with the most recent and scientific information about animals in a very simplified format. If you are a poultry farmer, you will be more scared of this rainy season because of the mortality you will face and also the lot of diseases which will be coming to your farm. And also, there will be a lot of feed intake, but there will be less production. And in this scenario, a few managemental tips which we are sharing in this video will be more helpful for you to have a better production. To know the managemental tips, please stick onto the video until end. In this video, we will be seeing how to manage a poultry shed in a rainy season. Firstly, you need to see all the possible leakages in the shed, and also you need to close it as soon as possible, especially in the roof. And also the roof's overhang should be minimum 1.5 to 2 feet. This overhang could be built through a tarpaulin sheet or a polythene sheet. Care should also be taken in the surrounding of the poultry shed, where minimum 5 meters surrounding to the poultry shed should be clean with no bushes and grasses. And also area around poultry shed should be flat and slope, where the slope should end in a drainage system. If there is any water logging in the surrounding area, this may cause a huge problem of insects in the poultry shed. The side cover of the poultry shed should be completely covered with the polythene sheet without any gap. If the ammonia concentration is increasing in the poultry shed, then you should release the polythene sheet from top to bottom. In case of heavy rain, if the water is drizzling from the small gap in the front and the back of the poultry shed, you can close this gap with a gunny bag so that it will ensure the drizzling and also a good ventilation. In any poultry production, the litter management is very essential, especially in the rainy season where the litter's moisture content increases. It predisposes the birds to many of the bacterial diseases and also coccidiosis, because of which the litter should be kept dry throughout the rainy season. To ensure this one, you can store 20% extra litter in your storehouse. You would have noticed too much of caking in this rainy season. To get rid of this, you need to do racking every day twice. If you want to reduce the bacterial and coccidiosis infection from the litter, then you need to sprinkle the lime powder on litter and mix it thoroughly, and you can use it in the poultry shed. When it comes to feed management, you should store the feed at least 1 feet above the ground level in a wooden plate and also 1 feet away from the wall. If you are procuring your feed from a faraway places, then you should make sure the transport vehicle is completely closed and there is no any leakage inside the vehicle. If you are a feed manufacturer, then you should remember the feed has more chances of getting mycotoxin infection, because of which you can use a good toxin binder and also a good antioxidant. And the shell grid availability will be very less in the rainy season, because of which you can store the shell grid priorly. When it comes to water management, water usually available in the rainy season is usually dirty and also having large particles. To get rid of this, you can use a filter to get rid of big particles, and also you can settle the water for 24 hours so that the big particles will get settled in the floor. And also the upside water can be used for your shed. If needed, you can also use the bleaching powder in your water. And also remember to wash your drinkers twice daily so that you can avoid lot of bacterial and fungal infection. If you are doing brooding using a charcoal, make sure the charcoal is completely dry and there is no any wetness in it, because the wetness in the charcoal will increase the smoke, which causes a carbon dioxide toxicity to the birds. Apart from all these things, in rainy season, you need to be more aware of the safety measures in your poultry shed, especially the electricity leakage or the wire cutoff, because this is not only dangerous for your birds, it is also dangerous for your labors. If this video was helpful for you, please like the video and also share this video to your farmer friends, and also subscribe to the channel Anything About Animals so that you will get lot of informative videos like this. If you have doubt on raining any animals or any bird, you can ask the doubt in the comment section so that we will answer to that doubt as soon as possible. You can also be connected to us on Facebook or Instagram. Until we post our next video, good luck and bye everyone.